Okay, we're heading downtown. We're in LA, going to Main Street. We're going to visit Ruth Meghiddo, who is the founder of Farm Urbana. Farm Urbana is an architectural crossover to urban gardening. And we're going to take a look at one of Ruth's installations at building downtown. So we're in LA. We made it. We got through the traffic. We had a little bit of an incident with a helicopter that kept us from filming for a little while. But we made it here, and I'm standing here with Ruth Meghiddo. Ruth is an architect, and she's an urban farming consultant. And she's really graciously invited us up to one of her installations here in the Fashion District, Warehouse District of LA to tell us a little bit about urban farming. So thanks, Ruth.
Yes. Welcome to my farm.
Thanks.
So this is, I like to call it a farm because it is actually a campion, a pilot, what could be a real farming. And if you look around and see how extended roof areas are around, we can talk about acres of food producing good stuff for people to create communities, to eat healthy food that they grow with their own hands. I specialize in tower gardens. It's a very sustainable system because in the tower we can grow, as you say, variety. That's a very simple yet very sophisticated system. We have a container, as you see, that's water, that we put the nutrients in it. It's in a liquid form, two kinds of liquid nutrients. And you see there is an opening.
Yeah, so there's no soil in there.
It's just all water. Completely no soil. You can hear the noise. There is a pump, if you notice, a little pump inside. And the water, it's pushed up to here. And you can tell there is water showering the roots from above. It's a new technology because allows the plants to be oxygenated in between showering. That we have a timer next to the electrical outlet that gives you 15 minutes on, 15 minutes off the water to run. So it actually saves the water because it's recycling.
It looks like it's modular.
Can you
keep adding these?
Of course.
How many of these towers do you have up here?
Right here at the moment we have 6. When people see the beginning, they are kind of suspicious. What is it? How it? Is it good? Is it? And after they try and enjoy once, they come here all the time. People have lunch, have parties.
So can you point out some of the things that are growing? I think I'd recognize some, but
go ahead. Let's see what you know.
All right, let's see. We'll try
What is that?
That's Swiss chard.
Perfect.
Ruby chard.
Yes, this is here.
Okay. It looks like we've got some green leaf lettuce.
That's romaine. Yes, we have 2 kinds of romaine.
So you got beans, cherry tomatoes.
Yes. You have nasturtium.
Now,
if you know,
it's
this
an
is
edible
a
flower.
Very yep. nice, edible, a good flavor, a peppery one. And it's maybe the only plant that you can eat everything.
So, you know, one of the things we're really interested in
is
ways in which we can use information technology to, work with this system,
yes.
to work with some of the things that people are already doing. I noticed one place in information
numbers.
You got numbers all over this.
That's really not my contribution. It was somebody, a tenant. They did that just for kind of reference.
Well, I mean, just the fact that someone felt that there was a need to start cataloging.
Yes.
And I mean, this is information technology, right?
This is assigning data. Right.
And, I could imagine that maybe an enterprising student or someone who's in information technology might say, well, what if we connected these numbers to some sort of a log? Maybe there's an app that we could use to help keep track of health and maybe, how much sun they're getting. And
I would love to talk to you guys about that in the future. I have all sorts of fantasies. Those plants are a month old. Imagine that you are cultivating, that you get a piece of property. and you want to create a farm, how long will it take you to do that?
For me?
for you, at least.
Yeah.
Yeah, until they start preparing. Well, here it's much less. Plants grow faster, and can you tell that if you are rigorous about the feeding, measuring the pH, this is a very important part of this.
So measuring the pH of the water and the nutrients.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I measure usually before I want to see what's happening, and then once you put the feeding, it kind of corrects itself. The pH is always right when the feeding is right.
Uh-huh.
And look, you can't be not successful, and you relatively depend on the weather much less than otherwise, because you have that possibility of moving around, of when the why those are here in the shade, because we had several weeks of heat. Otherwise, those should be in the sun.
Right, so these are all on wheels. All the towers are on
wheels. Right. One thing that I'm going to do very soon, I already have a consultant that we were talking about a solar system to feed those six towers that we have here. So we have two solar electricity
run the pumps. Exactly. That's tremendous, yeah.
They are right now looked to electricity. There are calls of cords, extension cords. I don't like that. I like to be independent. I don't want to have interruptions. So solar would be a simple, very simple hookup to two small panels. But now talking about IT, this could be easily controlled, the watering, right?
Yeah, I mean, I even think like, this is a little nuts, but you could imagine that if these towers were right on the edge of a shady space, you could have a sensor that's keeping track of how much sun they get. And if it was just enough automation that it could just push them forward into the sun, mm-hmm. or pull a shade down and retract a shade to control the right amount of sun. I would be inclined to call this a rooftop garden, but you're very specific about wanting to say this is an urban farm, a rooftop farm.
That's right.
Why do you draw that distinction? I'm sure it's very intentional.
It is.
Yeah.
Because what I'm doing, it's farming. Gardening, it's flowers, it's a little bit of edible. This is serious stuff. This is farming, this is providing food. Think of it, in one tower, you have 28 plants. This is the beauty of it. You can pick and choose what you like, what your family likes.
Your focus in calling it a farm is that the goal of this is, although food. It may be beautiful because it's green and it can be constructed in a nice way, the goal is really to get food out of it.
Food. And that's this is food and quality of food.
This is
high quality of food. This is definitely a way I'm thinking health. I'm thinking community. You have to see when people come here, I don't know, even later today, have lunch. You know, they don't know each other. They say, oh, did you try this? Did you try that?
So speaking of taste, can we do a taste test?
Of course. This is arugula.
Okay.
In order to show you that's okay.
I want some too.
All right.
And it's good for the plants to be trimmed here. And you want this. This is an interesting one.
That's like a red leaf lettuce?
Yes. Rosa.
You can have one.
Here I have at least 9-10 different kind of lettuces.
It's kind of hard to explain that this lettuce has flavor. Like. So as opposed to the gray lettuce you're kind of used to at the dining hall. Sorry. Do you have problems with pests?
Yes, there is. Once in a while, there are pests because they come, you know, mm-hmm. from where. But there are fantastic, easy ways to get rid of them because you see everything, and if there is a dropping for something, you see it right away and you right away take care of it. Mm-hmm. Either you usually the water, if there is something minuscule, beginning of something, I water them and that's it.
Like here you got a bee. Phil, can you get this bee?
Where's the bee? Oh, there it is. Wait, that's not a bee. That's a bee fly, I think.
Do you plant from seeds or seedlings or?
Yes. Well, I should mention there is a system here, and I can show you. There's a rock wool that comes into this net pot, and that's where the seeds start growing.
You started them from seeds.
Yes, I start everything from seeds.
Okay, that's tremendous.
And I pick and choose. I say now we are August, September. Oh, now I'm thinking, kale. Those are fall, winter stuff.
The fancy restaurant has come to me,
yes.
And I am now going to eat the flower. This is my bunny impersonation.